Please take a seat. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and I am the life. Whoever believes in me, though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die." Good morning and welcome to our special service and time together today when we have this chance to grieve, to remember, and to celebrate the life of Dawn Bond. To support and comfort Mike, Sam and their wider family and their friends at this time of loss, and then at the end of our time together to commend Dawn to the eternal loving care of God. Thank you for coming, as I say, and some of you have come a long distance, so a real welcome to you. Some of you may not be familiar with the building, so if you'll excuse me, I'll just get the practical bit out of the way first of all. In the very unlikely event of us having to vacate the hall, then those sitting in this half of the hall, the fire exits are out through there, through the double doors, and then round to meet on the grass outside the place opposite there. If you're in the rear section of the hall, then you'll go out through the rear doors or the entrance doors where you came in. So that's just the housekeeping things dealt with. As I say, you may not be familiar otherwise with the layout of the building. Although Dawn sadly has not been able to meet with us at Wellsprings for over 4 years, both Mike and Dawn have been members at Wellsprings for over 30 years. We were trying to work it out. 32 years, I think, is the time that they've been associated with us as a church here and very much a part of this Christian fellowship. During that time, Sam was born, and we had the pleasure of seeing Sam grow up from a toddler to a young boy and now into the fine young man he is today, and we give thanks to God for him as well. Shall we begin with a short prayer? Heavenly Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. And although we naturally feel the loss of Dawn, we thank you that we do not grieve as those who have no hope in Christ. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. One of the things I discovered over the years is that Dawn loved to sing. She joined with us many times at the Christmas carol service, singing in the choir then. And so it won't come as any surprise to you to know that Dawn left a whole long list of all the songs that she would like us to include in our Thanksgiving service this morning. And so all the ones that have been sung before the service and the ones we'll sing during it and the one at the end when the service is here is over were all chosen by Dawn. So they're personal favourites of hers, and we're very glad to be able to join together in singing those. So we stand to sing and the very first one of those particular songs that she's chosen. The words are in your order of service, so you can follow the words from there. They won't come up on the screen for the sake of simplicity. So let's start and sing, "How Great Thou Art."
to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And through the woods and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees. When I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in, that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior, how great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then shall I how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
Thank you. Please be seated. I'm sure Dawn would have approved of that singing. It's great to join together in praising God like that. I'm going to ask Dawn's brother-in-law, Brian West, to come now and to share some of his own thoughts and pass on some of his tributes and those that have been given to him to share with us. Thank you, Brian.
Isn't it marvellous to think of Dawn planning this service? I had a bit worried because, I don't know if you noticed, but the coffin was on the move earlier and Mike had to give a stern word to her to stay still. But that was typically Dawn, wasn't it? So it's great to be here. Thank you all for coming. Thank you for a lot of you wearing colours. That's tremendous. And we're here to celebrate the life. Perhaps that's a little bit different from what you're normally used to, but we're here to celebrate the life. And I want to thank Phil and Jackie Bedford for all their help with Dawn. They did a lot of pastoral care and took communion to their house, etc., and looked after them. And thank you to Wellspring for your the opportunity of using the hall here and to the excellent choir here. That's very good. And I'd also like to thank Matt and Helen Lewis. Matt is the pastor of Bethesda Church in Dinas Powys near Cardiff. And they're over today because Dawn and Mike used to link up and still do link up with them online for the services. And it's where we attend, so it's very good for them to be here. So we're here to celebrate the life of Dawn Helena Mansfield, who was born in Nailsea, Somerset, on the 27th of April, 1961. She was the fourth daughter of Mr. and Mrs. J.A. Mansfield, and we have the daughters here, Pat, Carol, and Ruth, and we thank you for coming. And there was 19 years between Pat and Dawn. And when I was courting Pat, we used to take Dawn out, and everybody in the pram, everybody thought she was our daughter. The fact that we hadn't even got married then, out in those years today. I mean, we're celebrating 61 years this year, so it's a long time back. But, you know, so we really grew up with her. Her father, Jim, was a painter and decorator with his own business in Nailsea, employing several men. Dawn was educated in the local schools in Nailsea. She enjoyed her schooling and was very good at languages. My son and daughter remember our visits to Nailsea. Dawn used to take them upstairs to play schools. Dawn was a good head teacher. She certainly kept them in order for us. And Mark, the other son, said, "I remember Dawn. She was more than an auntie. She was more like another big sister. They always had a lot of fun and laughter when Dawn was around. And more recently, they played Scrabble Online with Dawn. Unfortunately, she won most times." That was Dawn determined, wasn't it? Upon leaving school, age 18, she wanted to train as an air hostess. But those that you know her, being 6 foot, her height was a problem. She was too tall for the aircraft of the day. Instead, Dawn joined the entertainment team at Farley Hospital in Flexborton for about a year. She then applied for nurse training at Sandhill Park Hospital in Bishop's Lydia. This was a hospital whose residents were physically and mentally handicapped. She qualified after 3 years and worked on various wards. Her loving and caring nature was evident to all those she cared for and those who worked with her. Dawn was promoted to ward sister and set up a day unit called Greenfields, which was a great success. The hospital closed in 1991. She then applied for and got a manager's job running a residential home for handicapped children with 20 staff. In 2004, she left to work at Musgrave Park Hospital on the stroke unit, Dunkery Ward, as a physio assistant, where she met many friends. And it's evident by that there was a large group of who came from Musgrave, and it was a pleasure to see you. Thank you for honouring Dawnie, and thank you for coming. And she eventually retired in 2019. Dawn met Mike in 1987, and they were married in 1990 at Southfield Church in Nailsea. And Sam was born in 1999. I told him how old you are now, Sam. The early experience of playing head teacher with my children enabled her in encouraging Sam with his learning. I know she had quite a struggle to get Sam to learn, but in the end, she was very proud of his achievements. And look at him now, where he is. He's a premier man. Well done. Mike, you told me what a wonderful wife you had. You could not have found a better one. Dawn was very loving and caring. Our prayers are with you that God will sustain and comfort you. Dawn always enjoyed planning and going on family holidays. We drove to many different countries in Europe and some lovely times. I couldn't count how many miles you drove, but a normal trip was 2,500 to 3,000 miles, and I think, cool, fancy going all that way. But COVID in 2020 put a stop to that. However, they did manage one last trip in November 22, once restrictions had eased, to La Rochelle in France, one of her favorite places. Here comes the strange part. Now, in 2021, Dawn was diagnosed with a lung problem called mesothelioma. Is it? What's come on there, sis? What is it? I'm only a country bumpkin, all right? This was caused by asbestos. And after they discovered this news, Mike and Dawn and Sam started making as many memories as they could with days out, weekends away, and plenty of family time. Dawn was always giving us a real welcome and went out of her way in caring for our needs when we visited. There are several things she spoilt me. Yeah, she spoilt me, Mike, with sending cream teas, some coming from Devon and some coming from Cornwall. I think she was trying to fox me which way the cream went. And saffron cake. She was quite a tease with her visits to Gay's ice creamery, as the picture shows. She always pulled my leg on this. That clotted cream, great dollop of. She delighted in sitting next to me while she crunched on her crisp. I don't know if you've any had that experience, but I've never known such noisy crisp, and I kept wondering where she got the variety from. And the other problem to me was breakfast, when out came something beginning with M. No, not Marmalite. Not marmalade, it was Marmite. I nicknamed Yucky Yuck, I can't stand the stuff. Sam and Dawn delighted in putting it as close to me as possible. I think she got this mischievousness from her mother, who enjoyed making mince pies at Christmas time. They all look very nice, but on taking a bite, you may get one filled with cotton wool instead of mincemeat. It was sad seeing Dawn suffer in her mobility and pain as a cancer took hold. Many of us were amazed at her determination to fight this. Yes, she was still very positive in still wanting to show her caring nature. After all, she always cared for others. There was no way we were going to care for her. And I know Mike expected and Dawn expected her to care for him, but it turned out the other way around. But when she could no longer do things herself, she had to accept others caring for her. And the family would like to publicly thank Debbie and Margaret for their loving care they gave to Dawn, looking after her personal needs, spending time talking, which helped the hours pass by. They were there first thing in the morning till late at night, including all through the night sometimes. Thank you both for caring for Dawn and the wonderful support that Colin and Annette provided in helping in many directions, including meals, etc. And you're still helping, I think, with the paperwork, aren't you? And thank you to Becky, Mike's daughter. It's been an interesting note. You've been in charge of the shopping and keeping the pantry rolling and helping Mike on various things to sort out. And we thank you for that. Thank you also for Mitch, who was an extra pair of hands in the house and garden and on the visits, which Dawn appreciated. And I couldn't go without thanking Barry. Can you tell Barry? Right, can't miss Barry. Barry was the Jack Russell, and wherever he visited Dawn, he sensed when she was in pain, nuzzled up to her and wouldn't settle till he sat on her lap and cuddled in, and that's where he stayed. And it was evident when Dawn was in pain. He knew when sometimes we didn't know. Thank you to the local doctors and nurses also for attending to her needs. As Dawn grew weaker, St. Margaret's Hospice offered her extra care she needed in the lovely grounds surrounded her room, especially her hearing the birds twittering. You know, somebody said to me the other day, "Are you on Twitter?" I said, "No, that's what the birds do." But I remember being there. I don't know if it's on your spill or not. Am I jumping on your tray? Yeah. Got to be under authority. We were there in the room, and the birds were singing, and Dawn said, "Can't we sing something?" So we sang that old song, "The Birds Upon the Treetops," sang their song. And then afterwards, she wanted to sing Blessed Assurance. And she couldn't have the volume to sing, but she was mouthing it. And then we tried one another, and she said, "That's enough." But really, her joy came through, and that was the last day she was alive, you know, and we saw her joy in praising the Lord. I want to thank the staff of St. Margaret's Hospice for the amazing care you gave Dawn, the kind of care she gave out over her life. You gave it with dignity and quality of life. I know you are personally affected by the bereavement of those you care for. Thank you doesn't seem enough, but thank you anyway. And there are boxes here if you would like to give anything in memory of Dawn towards St. Margaret's Hospice. So Dawn has gone in advance of us to be with her Saviour. And one day, those who have put their trust in Jesus will all unite in heaven. So let's celebrate the life she shared with us and draw on those precious memories. It's not a day to be sad, it's a day to rejoice in all those memories that we have, and let's celebrate that. And we as a family would love it if you all came and shared your memories with us at Romwell. That's right, then, Mike? Yeah, we'd love to hear of your experiences with Dawn. I've only covered a few. We could go on a couple of days, really, if we really gave a full tour of it. So please come and share with us, and thank you for listening.
Thank you, Brian. Thank you, Brian, for that wonderful tribute. Yeah, and I think Barry might put in an appearance when we come to the reflections moment in the service. So he features in there. Met him a couple of times when we called to see them. In fact, the song we're going to sing next is another of Dawn's favourites, and was one that we did quietly sing together, Jackie and myself, when we visited Mike and Dawn in their home on various occasions over the past couple of years, as Brian, I think, intimated that we shared communion with them, and it was our privilege to do that. They were really special times for Jackie and myself to do that and to pray with them and to support them. And this particular song, All I Once Held Dear, is really a witness and a testimony to Dawn's life of faith, of how she lived what she believed. And I'm sure many of you have worked with her and know her will know that that was the case, as she bore testimony to her Christian faith, her faith in the Lord Jesus. So we're going to stand and sing this song together. All I once held dear, built my life upon, all this world reveres, and wars to own, all I once thought gain, I have counted loss, spent and worthless now compared to this, knowing you, Jesus, knowing you. And now we remember that she is in the very presence of our Lord right now, as we remember her and give thanks for her life. Her faith in Jesus is something which has now given place to the reality of being in his very presence. So as we sing this, we do it in memory of Dawn, but may it also be a reflection of our hearts as well, to recognize that everything that this world wars to own and fights for is nothing compared with the knowledge of knowing Jesus as our Lord and Savior. We have to leave everything of this world behind. We go to be with Jesus when we die. That's why it's great gain. Let's stand and worship together.
All I once held dear. righteousness, and I love you, Lord. Now my heart's desire is to know you more, to be found in you, and known as yours, to possess by faith what I could not earn, or surpassing gift of righteousness. Knowing you, Jesus, knowing you, there is a greater thing. You're my all, you're the best, you're my joy, my righteousness, and I love.
I'm going to ask Dawn's eldest sister to come and fill in all the gaps that Brian left in his tribute, and I'm sure that there are very, very many. Thank you, Pat.
Well, I didn't think I'd be finding myself here, standing here today. I was starting to write things for somebody else to read, but that little voice inside me said, you have to do this. So here we go. My youngest sister, Dawn, affectionately known as Dawnie, we always called her that, has left behind her a legacy, one of love, care, and compassion. Thank you. Great, thank you. Okay. So I'm sure you all got that first bit. So she left this legacy of love, care, and compassion. And she was and still is beautiful inside and out, and always with a radiant smile. I'm sure you all know that. Even her birth brought great joy to our mum and dad after a sad loss of a baby boy at birth, who we called Peter. Dawn was only 2 and a half when we got married in 1963. But she was the cutest bridesmaid, as you can imagine. She always had that little edge to herself, didn't she? When we had a young family, she'd often come and spend time with us at our home and on holidays. And because she was nearer the ages than most aunts is to our children, they had great fun together. It wasn't like an auntie and children being looked after. They had fun together because they were similar ages. All through her life, she had that joyful, caring nature. For everyone. And only now am I finding out how many friends she gathered along the way over the years. Every one of us here today has experienced something of a legacy, of that legacy that she's left, one of love, care, and compassion, which flowed out from her. Dawn also lived out a strong, deep faith in her Saviour and Lord, and was eager to serve others in need at every opportunity. She was also gifted with a delightful singing voice, and she enjoyed being part of the choir at the church here. And in the latter years, singing along with the worship songs of Bethesda Chapel's online services. It might seem odd that she chose a church in Dennis Powers to log into, but this is where we live, and she had visited the church on many occasions in the past years and sort of felt like home. While in this past year in particular, it's been a painful and difficult time for Dawn, her family, and her lovely friends, it's our duty now to carry on the legacy of love, care, and compassion for others that she did. She would also want you to know her Saviour Jesus, who has always been faithful through the good and the bad times. Dawny would say to you, he is only a prayer away from making him your Saviour too. Often I would send her a prayer, a song, or a verse which brought encouragement to her and to me. Dawn shared how much this particular one meant to her as the choir sang it at the end of each practice, which she said she really missed. This is the priestly blessing from Numbers 6, 24 to 26. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen.
Thank you, Pat. Just a few verses I'll read from Psalm 92. It is good to praise the Lord and make music to your name, O Most High. Proclaiming your love in the morning and your faithfulness at night. For you make me glad by your deeds, Lord. I sing for joy at what your hands have done. How great are your works, Lord. How profound your thoughts. And we're going to join with the psalmist now in singing another great song together. Matt Redman's song, 10,000 Reasons, to bless the Lord, to worship his holy name. Let's do that together as we stand.
Rich in love and you're slow to anger.
will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Strength is failing, the end draws near and my time has come, still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then
have a seat. So we've listened to the tributes and memories brought by Brian and Pat. And now we'll have 5 minutes or so to reflect personally on our individual memories of Dawn. They will be different for each one of us. They will be special to each one of us, and we want to give you the opportunity to give thanks for the life of Dawn and for every memory you have of her. It's going to be a rolling PowerPoint showing some pictures. There'll be some there which might cause you to smile. I hope they do. There'll be some there maybe that you're part of. There will be many things there that will jog memories. And I hope we can use this time just to be thankful and joyful, because that's what Dawn wanted this service to be. Yeah. A time of thanksgiving and a time that was marked by joy, not sadness, because we share her faith. And we know that Dawn is not here. This is not the end of Dawn. Her physical frame is finally given up. Her strength has failed, as we sang in that song. But for 10,000 years and forevermore, she's now singing with her new body and in full voice. And we thank God for that. So we'll just quietly watch this as it comes and as it goes around. There's a chance to meditate and give thanks. And Marilyn will play another of... We'd love to have sung this one, but thought we'd just put it into place. Be still, find rest, my soul. Thanks, Tiff. Wonderful memories. Various things which I'm sure we will have remembered in our different ways. Because Dawn was a much loved wife. And mum, and sister, auntie, work colleague, dear friend. And we thank God for her and for every memory we have of her. Before we move to the commendation and closing prayer, we'll stand to sing a song which I think encapsulates all that we believe as Christians. And also all that characterized Dawn's personal and real faith in Christ. And the difference that makes for this life now, but also as we anticipate that glorious consummation of all God's plans and purposes when Jesus Christ comes again. And dawn may have preceded us, but we will join her again. Whether that's through death or whether that's when Christ himself comes with those who have fallen asleep in him. In Christ alone, my hope is found. I hope that's true for you. If not, then I know it would be Dawn's prayer, as Brian's already, or Pat already shared, I think. Her prayer would be that if you don't have that hope, that you would cry out and receive the forgiveness that Jesus died to bring us and the new life that he gives for this life and beyond. In Christ alone, let's stand and sing. Take your seats for a moment. Just to say again a big thank you to all of you for coming and joining together with us today to remember and celebrate Dawn. I would say that there will be a private family committal at the Taunton Deane Crematorium immediately following this service, and that this will be just for the immediate family and those who were part of the small team that were put together to provide that much needed support during the last 3 years in particular for Mike and for Dawn. That said, you are, as I think Brian's already said in his tributes, you are all warmly invited to meet again with the family at Rumwell Farm Shop and Cafe for celebrations there to continue and to share food together. And the family will join us at Rumwell as soon as the committal service is finished at the crematorium. Again, just to mention that there is a retiring box there for any donations that you might want to make, which will go to St. Margaret's Hospice, who provided much needed care and support during Dawn's final weeks. So let us now pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for Dawn, for her life, her love, her friendship, for the difference she made to so many people's lives. Come now, Lord, and draw near to all who mourn. Especially be close to Mike, Sam, Mitchell, and all of Dawn's family and friends at this time. That casting all their care on you, they may know the reality of your love filling and surrounding them through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now let us commend Dawn to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Heavenly Father, by your mighty power you gave us life. And in your love you have given us new life in Jesus. We now entrust Dawn to your merciful keeping, in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who died and rose again to save us, and is now alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit in glory forever. Amen. Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you before his glorious presence without fault and with great joy, to the only God, our Saviour, be glory, majesty, power and authority through Jesus Christ our Lord, before all ages, now and forevermore. Amen. Pat mentioned that the benediction was something that Dawn loved to sing, and the music group is going to sing that to us now as the coffin is taken to the crematorium for the family committal there. So please stand and hear the words of the benediction sung to each one of us.
And keep you.
Thank you. Please take a seat. That's the end of our Thanksgiving service. If you want to make your way over at your own time to Rumwell and join with the family there for the refreshments, I'm sure they'll be delighted to see you. Go now in peace.